the Entertainment Tonight birthdays, which singer celebrates his birthday the same day as his younger brother? Is it Josh Groban, Justin Timberlake, or Usher? Your answer is next in the ET Weekend Birthdays.
Okay.
Yes, the show was definitely kicking in there.
Dallas Corby stopped just a moment before having plastic surgery. She was looking for how Cam was able to sleep.
Yeah, one word.
Wow.
The 21-year-old reality star originally gained fame back in 2011 when she had 16 married 51-year-old actor Doug Hutchison. Instead, she's had some plastic surgery, done some TV, and taken lots of photos. Morgan let us tag along in the OR when she had her latest procedure. Courtney is a bundle of nerves, which is kind of surprising. This reality star has never been shy about flaunting her looks. This music video is even called reality. And the 21-year-old has definitely had work done before. Courtney's admitted to a breast augmentation, temporary lip fillers, and porcelain veneers. Today, she's opting for a nose job.
Like, I'm not loud about my bump on the side of my nose. And like, pictures or carpets, I just feel really, like, self-conscious about this bump.
You're so scared.
Comforting Courtney is her husband, Doug, now 55. He was in Lost and Green Mile. The two met right after Courtney had competed in the Miss Teen Washington USA pageant.
I was in the Donald Trump pageant, and, you know, all the women voted me zero, all the judges, and the men voted me 10.
Courtney had since appeared in couples therapy and the British version of Big Brother.
I enjoy attention, obviously.
And she always claimed her looks were natural.
I've had no surgery, Dad.
But 2 years after this appearance on Dr. Drew, Courtney did have breast implants.
I'm not ashamed of the way I look. I'm happier now.
Which brings us to today's procedure, part cosmetic, but also a rhinoplasty to correct breathing problems.
Debated and kind of like pulled out, got nervous. So it took me a really long time to kind of warm up to it.
The hard part's over.
The procedure, which costs $13,000 to $15,000, lasts 2 hours. And even though she's covered with scary-looking bandages now, Courtney will only be in the clinic for another 3 or so hours. The total recovery is 7 to 10 days.
That's 10 days. No restrictions, full athletic program.
I'm very happy my bump isn't there anymore.
2 weeks later, Courtney's happy with the results, and this may not be her last trip to the plastic surgeon.
I guess when gravity starts to take over, it took here and there, but nothing excessive.
Courtney's plan is to shoot another music video, and she's also taking part in Lifetime's new reality series, The Mother-Daughter Experiment Celebrity Edition, that debuts March 1st.
Yeah, look at that little Cool J getting in the groove, loving the culture club at the big age party last weekend.
Last weekend.
Also feel the love after the music, man.
Good evening. From the moment I heard about Boy George back in the
80s. And the thousands of people in shelter room were singing along with some of the biggest music stars of the 80s. At least they got it.
Like, what is it that they say now?
Get off.
Go!
Don't believe Rick for a minute. 13,000 fans flashing back to the 80s as iHeartRadio gave nothing but love to Billy Idol, Tears for Fears, and the ultimate new wavers, Culture Club. Staying together and still making good music.
I think having a few old gaps right
from the beginning. Is that right?
Right, a lot of long gaps.
Yes, we do if we want to do it again. More marriages would survive if black people lived in separate houses.
Exactly. Loverboy gave the crowd a heavy dose of 80s rock. And Tears for Fears rocked one of their classics. Paul Abdul was there, and E.T. was backstage at the Forum in Los Angeles with 80s icons behind every corner.
This homage to Mike Jackson, I know you were close to him.
This is actually homage to myself. This was a jacket that I wore during my first televised performance at the Nickelodeon Kids' Choice Awards in 1986.
Well, it was more like 1989, Corey. But hey, at least
jacket still fits. Meanwhile, Billy Idol did his Rebel Yell bare-chested. With the Rebel Yell, she what do you have to have in your dressing room? Now, is there something that Billy Idol has got to have?
Well, there was quite a few things in the old days.
Oh,
that
were well.
Super necessary.
What about this new video of yours, mister?
I like this party up. The first single, if there was a single, I don't know if they even have singles anymore. No, the first free download.
Boy George brought the evening to a close with a touching tribute to the late David Bowie and shared with us just how big a fan he really is. I did not know you were
here. It's
beautiful. The concert airs on Audience Network next month, but fans can also expect to see Boy George on Celebrity Apprentice when Arnold Schwarzenegger takes over for Donald Trump.
Arnold is brilliant.
Is he good?
He's funny. He's charming. He's got some good one-liners. And he's not as, bless Donald Trump, he's not as rude as Donald Trump.
There was another big reunion last weekend, I'm talking about this picture.
Oh yeah, look how awesome they are, right? Beyonce, Kelly Rowland, and Michelle Williams all together again, celebrating Kelly's 35th birthday at the Sunset Tower Hotel in West Hollywood. I mean, man, what a girl squad.
We'll be right back.
Look at all those famous faces and birthdays this weekend. Kate Mara is 33, Chelsea Clinton is 36, and Bernadette Peters, the Broadway mama, is celebrating turning 68. Now take a final look at your choices. Which singer celebrates his birthday the same day as his younger brother? That is Josh Groban, who is 35 this weekend. Happy birthday to him and his little bro, Chris.
E.T. at the Oscars with Josie.
Tomorrow, I know.
Worst dressed Monday, only on E.T.
I mean,
Before we go, check out frontman Joe Jonas' band, DNCE, and their video for Cake by the Ocean. This is the official live version.
The group just announced they will be opening for Selena Gomez on her revival tour, kicking off May 6th.
Enjoy it and the rest of your weekend, everyone. Bye.
Let's start living dangerously.